Namaste, friends.
Namaste.
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 Welcome to our daily satsang gathering, meeting. Satsang means meeting in truth. That's what the word satsang means in Sanskrit. Meetings in truth.
Speak up a little.
Oh, there's mics down there. Yeah. Meetings in truth, for those of you hard of hearing like me. I can't hear very well either.
And just wanted to say big, big thank you for all the beautiful birthday love that you guys showered on me yesterday. And it was just totally, totally beautiful. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I felt like we all had that birthday together.
Yeah.
It was really so nice. So it's also good it's over, isn't it? You can move on.
I stopped counting when I had the heart operation and when I got to 70, which was around about that time. And then I thought, I'm not counting anymore now. I'm just going to float in my 70s, you know. And so whenever you guys ask me how old I am now, I always say I'm in my 70s because I'm not too sure exactly how old I am. David knows, but of course. But for me, I'm just floating now, which is good. But David's still young, you know, 50 years old. It's a beautiful time, beautiful time. Yeah, you're going to have an amazing time.
And today's the day that we released a new track, which is very close to our hearts. It's the Om meditation. Maybe some of you already saw the post. And it took us only about 30 years to get that together, because it's been there like this, and we haven't done it for so long. So finally, it's there for you to use, and it's a beautiful track to have in your space. Sometimes I feel this music could just be on very quietly in the background as a kind of those aroma lamps that diffuse the scent into the atmosphere, and you almost can't hear it or you can't perceive it, but it's there kind of making your space, our space, more sacred. And it's in the auspicious vibration of frequency of 432 hertz, which is said to be even more beneficial, healing and organic to our system. Mm. So it's maybe something to experiment with. We are just experimenting with it newly. We haven't gotten further into this until now. So
it's kind of difficult because all the instruments in the conventional Western music's tuned to 440, you know. So we have to have the whole band tuned down, and it's difficult for Manoj with the bansuri, although I think wouldn't make any difference to Manoj really. He would just be able to play whatever. Mm-hmm. Anyway, 4:35, it's good. 4:32.
Yes.
Yeah.
So that's the Om mantra, which you can find everywhere where you can find our music. And also just wanted to say one more time about tomorrow. It's a very auspicious day tomorrow. It's the 4th of the 4th, 2020, which makes it 3/4, as well as a very powerful astrological constellation tomorrow night here in this part of the world. I'll tell you the times later, but basically there's a portal or a constellation where is really very powerful for us to all meditate together. And there are quite a few activities being spread around where people are asking for 1 million people global meditation. And the great thing is that no matter which one of those we join, if we meditate, we are joining it and we are creating the uplifting of the field. And we are doing this together with Unify on Facebook, and there's a lot of beautiful people joining as the kind of facilitators of the meditation. It will be Deepak Chopra and Nassim Haramein and Manoj and us and Krishna Das and Sadhviji and Pujya Swamiji and so beautiful, many people. It'll be tomorrow night, 10:45 New York time, 7:45 LA time, and somewhere in the middle of the night, like 4:45 for Europeans. We're going to put up the times again, and it's just very auspicious if we really did that at that time for half an hour. So if you can get up that early or that late in that night and join, that would be very beautiful.
I can recommend that. I can actually recommend that to put an alarm clock on and go totally out of your normal comfort zone, get up, meditate, and then go back. It's actually an amazing experience. I've done it many times in the commune days when we were in the ashram. Really amazing. Very good. Anything to wake us up, huh? Yes. Anything to keep us in our conscious awareness, yeah. Freshness, yeah. That's what all this must be about. It's such a challenge. So that means there's a possibility to rise above it. If it's a challenge, it's not a challenge if it's something else, it's something else. But as a challenge, we recognize that there's a way through it, a way above it. The question is how and what. And I've seen a lot of stuff in the newspapers about what books to read, you know, and what movies to watch. And I don't really see many people in the world talking about accepting and going into a silent space, going in, using this as a possibility to go, instead of going out looking for distractions. And we can't go out physically, so it's a clue. There must be something inside us that is peaceful and at rest, and that's meditation, and that's what we're doing here. Just to remind myself and all of you, that's what we're doing. It's not about hanging out. Of course it is, but it's also about hanging out in a deep way, so that we don't waste time. This time is precious.
Very precious.
Really precious time. So let's not waste it. Let's dive into this meditation together with gratitude and with love in our hearts for each other. Remember, we're a big family right now. So we're sending that connection out to every one of us. Every one of us, and it's coming back. You send your love, you send your connection consciously to all the beloveds, all your family. All our family, we are a big family, brothers and sisters all over the planet. And this is our challenge, and this is the gift that we've been given to rise above. And mantras are our friends in this, our good friends. Friend that will never let us down. Always there, our mantra. What do you say? Shall we begin?
Yes.
Okay. So, have you already put a flame to your candle, a flame to your incense, so that the room begins to be part of our temple? Then we again can imagine thousands of temples all over the planet, exactly the same moment, connecting. That's an amazing feeling. So light your candle, light your incense. If you don't have, bring your plant so that you feel close to your plant. These are the Mother Nature elements in our house, in our room, always there for us. Okay. And then when you've done that, let's close our eyes and take a moment to feel your body getting comfortable with your eyes closed, so you can begin to come home to ourselves, to our silent chord, a safe place, a safe place. Our sanctuary, our back is straight, and we take a deep breath as we straighten our spine. Take a deep breath, and a deep breath. Beginning to slow down. You come to a still point. Bringing our awareness to the sounds around. Connecting with our inner smile. Yes. Make it a joyful meditation. Doesn't have to be serious. And behind our closed eyes, we can raise our gaze to the third eye. Raise your gaze up to the third eye. And see if you can hold it there as David begins to chant the mantra Om. And chant in rhythm with Deva. And today we will do the Aum sound, Aum, with the mudra. Okay, Deva?
Let's take a deep breath.
Arms outstretched, moving into the channel and into the body. Touch your heart, arms outstretched. Bringing the sound into the channel with your hands and into the body, and holding your hands down.
Tat Savitur Varinya. Bhargo Divasya Dhinaye. Dhiyo Tat savitur varinam bhargo devasya dhimahi dhiyo yo na prachodaya. Om. tat savitur varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat.
Om bhuvasva tat savitur varenyam,
argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasva tat savitur varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasva tat savitur varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat.
Om bhuvasva tat savitur
varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasva tat savitur varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasva tat savitur varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat. Om bhuvasva tat savitur varenyam, argo devasya dhimahi, dhiyo yo na prachodayat.
Your eyes open. Take a moment. Close your eyes now. Take a moment just to come home. Take a deep breath.
You got it, got it.
No, do a song with me. I don't know what. Do you want to eat?
Still awake. I want to say a big love to our Brazilian friends. Today we have invited some Brazilian community friends, so it's a love to you. Hamilton actually wrote a love song to Brazil when we were there for the first time in 1996. We haven't played it for a long time.
Stretching out across this sacred land, walking slow, I got no special place to be. Cause paradise is right here in our stand. Yeah, see, you're joining our rehearsals. I know that I can't remember how to play that song, but here, this is, I've feel like playing this song today. I'm in a in this frame of mind, a mother inside. I said a prayer for the homeless, and I prayed no life is lived in vain. I lit a candle, I stepped out into the pouring rain, and I went looking for the mother inside. Just love you today. World was turning, I cried, tears of redemption and forgiveness. I crossed that river, I was looking for a witness. I was reaching out, I was reaching out for the mother inside. And the rain fell down like the tears of the virgin, tears of joy for all souls emerging as they reach for the mother inside. Mother inside. The sun rose at midnight, everything changed. My plans, my dreams, they were all rearranged. And I went singing for the mother inside. Yeah, my Shakti. We're all searching for the mother inside. Birth and death in every breath, one lover after another, as we search, as we search. Mother Earth, oh Mother Earth, what did we do? We took too much of you. While we were just reaching out, looking outside, looking outside for the mother inside. Never give up, never give up, no, no, never give up, never give up, never give up, never, never give up, searching for the mother, never give up, looking for the mother, never give up, singing for the mother, never give up, walking to the mother, never give up, singing for the mother inside, 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 singing for the mother inside. singing for the mother inside. Stay online a little longer today, shall we? It's okay. That's good. We chant Gati Gati. It's one of the many requests.
Mm-hmm. And actually, it's a mantra that Gati Gati, it's the last words of the Heart Sutra of Buddha, and the translation is so Gati means gone beyond. Gati Gati. Paragate, parasamgate, bodhisvaha, which means gone beyond, gone completely beyond, altogether beyond, oh, what an awakening. And it's really a mantra that reminds us of to let go of our identifications and attachments. And I think maybe in this time when so many of us aren't working the way we're working, maybe there's some, you know, identifications that are shook up, you know, like, who am I? Who am I when I'm not working? Just all these very set roles that we have in our day-to-day life, so much is shook up right now. And so this mantra reminds us of our true nature, which for me, when I sing Gati Gati, I feel this kind of clear blue sky. It feels like this space. And just reminds me that somebody just said to us, oh, wouldn't it be much better if we call it safe distancing rather than social distancing? It would have much, much more positive meaning. And I just thought safe spacing would be a really nice because we space out in a safe way, and that's
love is space.
And that's what we need to do inside. We need to find a safe space. So by safe spacing, we are also creating this inner space. So this is our safe spacing mantra. Gati Gati, para gati, para sam gati, bodhisvaha. Oh, what an awakening.
Yeah, and just to remind you again that these are not, when Deva says, oh, what awakening to go beyond, it's actually the sounds that take us there.
Hmm.
These sounds are
the safe space.
Where they are the vehicles that take us to that place of wow. The way Deva expresses it, she sees blue, she just sees space. You know, and that's her reality. Like when she sings it, she's gone beyond. And I think that so if we tune in to the mantras on this level, we can begin to really tune into them, so that it doesn't just become, I'm not really gone beyond right now, I'm singing it, I know what it means. But if we look to find out how to connect with those sounds, the sounds are the key. So how to connect when we chant Gati Gati? How do we chant them with the awareness and with the consciousness of going and letting these sounds take us beyond our minds into bliss? And that's the gift of such a beautiful mantra as this Gati Gati. So, and those, like David say, those feelings of stress there that keep us from this space of bliss, and the Gati Gati takes us there. Isn't that amazing? Oh yeah. Say the words one time so you know, in case you guys don't know it. Huh?
Gati Gati.
Gati Gati.
Para Gati.
Para Gati.
Para Sam Gati.
Para Sam Gati.
Bodhi.
Bodhi
Svaha.
Svaha, Svaha, Svaha. Okay. We'll help you. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Gati. What do you want to do?
Yeah, good.
Samasta sukino bhavantu loka samasta sukino bhavantu loka samasta sukino bhavantu. Deep breath. Let's just enjoy the silence a little longer together. So really no rush. Relaxing our shoulders, our bellies, the jaw, the mind, and the heart.
Becoming aware of your inner smile again. A sense of gratitude. Thankfulness.
Thank you so much for joining us, and tomorrow we'll see each other twice, our usual time at this time, and then again later on in the day or night for the global meditation. I'll post the times, and yes, together we can raise the vibration, raise the frequency. Namaste.
Namaste.
Lots of love.